IT organizations empower employees to be their most creative and productive in how they collaborate across physical and digital environments. As managers of an organization's infrastructure, you support teams across the company and across the world. This means not just enabling diverse workflows, but also balancing needs around security and compliance. I'm Alexander Luerta, and today I'm going to show you how Project for the Web makes it easy to support diverse needs and workflows. And these needs are diverse. For example, the workflows that a marketing team uses to get a product into customers' hands is very different from how the facilities organization supports the company's physical infrastructure. And in addition to these different organizational workflows, you have individuals and small teams who just need an easy way to manage their projects. And all of this is in the context of legal and compliance requirements. If you have a team in Europe that you need to support, you may need to think about data residency, which means that project information for that team needs to be stored in a European data center. Project for the Web simplifies these capabilities for your users. That's because Project for the Web is built on top of the Power Platform. Now, the Power Platform is a set of applications and capabilities that are there to make it easy for you to do things like visualize data, to build custom applications, and to create automations across the tools that your organization uses. At the heart of all this is the Dataverse. The Dataverse is essentially an Azure SQL database, but enhanced with powerful and easy-to-use tools for deploying and managing applications. And the Dataverse is what we're going to focus on when we talk about integrating Project into your organization. So when it comes to supporting the needs of diverse workloads, the key thing that we will be covering is the concept of Dataverse environments. You can think of an environment as an individual database with different properties, such as who can access it and what applications store data in it. Project for the Web supports three different types of environments. The default environment is there to help people quickly get started creating and managing projects. It is ideal for workflows that may be more ad hoc or for projects where the team spans a broad slice of the company. This is because everyone in the company is automatically a member of the default environment. The only thing you need to do to enable someone to create a work breakdown structure is to give them a license to project. Then that project manager will be able to work with stakeholders within her own team, as well as across the company. If you're looking to have more control over how project is used in your organization, or if you need to support teams that have diverse workflows, then you'll be working with production environments. Creation and deployment of project in a production environment is a manual process. In addition to creating the environment, you'll also spend time setting up security roles to limit the sets of users who can work within that environment. This work pays off in that you can start more advanced scenarios, such as enabling Project to support different workflows for different teams. Also, unlike the default environment, production environments can be backed up and restored. The last type of environment you can use Project with is there to support teams responsible for the creation, deployment, and support of custom applications within an organization. Sandbox environments are very similar to production environments, but give you a place to make changes to software without putting production workloads at risk. Once an issue is resolved, or once a custom application is ready for production, you can convert a sandbox environment into a production environment. Now that we have some background, I'll show you how to deploy Project in your organization. This will be a demo where I'll spend a few moments to familiarize you with the admin experience for environments. We'll create an environment and deploy Project into it. I'll then show you how you can easily apply a set of customizations to the Project experience with the Accelerator solution. And then you'll see how Project Home ties it all together for your end users. So let's get started. Everything starts in the Power Platform Admin Center. To get there, we visit admin.powerplatform.microsoft.com. The Power Platform Admin Center gives you everything you need to manage your environments. If you use any Dynamics 365 products, this may already be familiar to you. This is where you can see all the environments in your tenant, and you have several tools here to help you understand usage of them. You can see in this list that my tenant already has several environments. One of these is the default environment. Because we automatically deploy Project to the default environment, it is easy to get started. All you need to do is assign users a license to project, and you're good to go. Also, because the default environment has generous access rights, it is great for scenarios where you have teams that represent a broad slice of the company all working together in different projects. You'll see in here, we also already have a production environment. Based on the label for this one, it looks like it represents the USA region of our project management organization. Now let's go through an example. Let's say we have a facilities team for our US office that is looking to manage their work using Project for the Web. They are interested in deeply embedding Project into their processes and will likely need several customizations to the out-of-the-box experience. The first thing we'll do for them is to create an environment in which they can work. To do that, we press the New button up here. We'll give it a name. Let's call it Facilities USA. We'll go ahead and just create a production instance. Alternatively, we could create a sandbox instance and then create it to production later, but we're not planning on doing any extensive development. The next step is to give it a region. Since this team is in the US, we will choose a local region for them and press Next. This last step is important since we need to create a database where project data will be stored. It next asks us for information about the database. If we like, we can choose to give it a URL that is easy to remember, but it is not critical. There's one important setting on this page, which is this toggle here for Enable Dynamics 365 apps. This needs to be no, otherwise we won't be able to deploy project. And the last part is there's an optional step here, which is to give the environment a security group. This is a powerful way to limit access to the environment. Pressing the Select button will open up a list of different groups in your tenant. These are both M365 groups as well as security groups. A word of caution. If you have users who will be working extensively with stakeholders across the company, take care when leveraging the security option. With this form filled out, we then press Save. This is going to take a few minutes, so go ahead and grab a coffee. Once the environment is ready, the next step is to deploy project into it. First thing to do is click on the environment name. That will take you into this details page. At the top here, we have this resources menu, and in there, choose the Dynamics 365 apps option. This takes you to a page that shows the list of applications already installed in that environment. We now want to install Project, so let's press the Install App button in the top left. Pressing that button gives us a menu with a list of applications that can be installed in this environment. Towards the bottom of this list, you'll see one that says Microsoft Project Service Core. Choose that and press Next. Review the terms of service and go ahead and press Install. This process will take about 45 minutes. When it's done, you can then go ahead and configure Project.
Now, we've reached a great milestone. We've created an environment and deployed Project into it. Let's take a look at what the experience is like. Now, anyone who has the appropriate license, as well as the project user and project common roles, will be able to use Project for the Web. To reach Project, users open the Project Waffle, and in here, they have a list of applications available to them. Users will have a project power app for each environment that they're part of. Here, we have a power app for the default environment. And then below it, we have a power app for the production environment we just created and deployed Project to. You can see the name of the environment here below the name of the app. Let's open the app in the new environment and quickly review the experience. Now, this is the Project app that comes with all new installations of Project for the Web. Here on the left, we have a navigation menu, and along the top, we have a ribbon. Now, in this space, you'll have a list of all your projects. Right now, it's blank. Let's go ahead and create a new project. Press the New Project button, and we're asked to fill in some basic information about this project. So let's go ahead and give it a name. And then press Save. And with that, we have the bare bones needed to make a project. If you click over in the Tasks tab, this is where everyone goes to work, build out their schedule. And we can go ahead and create a new task. With that, we've just created a project and a schedule that is stored in this new environment. Now, in the beginning of the scenario, we described that the facilities team might want to have some customizations to this experience. Maybe they want to be able to manage an intake pipeline of projects. Maybe they want to organize projects into programs and do things like track risks and issues. Let's see what that may look like. To do that, we'll pop over to a different environment where we've already made those customizations. We'll click on the Office Waffle again, and this time we'll open up the Project Power App for the default environment. Here, we can see that there have been many customizations applied to projects. We've added some charts that are available in the middle of the page, and the navigation along the left rail offers more, including new entries for project request and program management. And what's great is that deploying this kind of experience for your users is easy. To do that, we'll take a look at the Power Apps Maker portal. To reach the portal, we'll go to make.powerapps.com. The Power App Maker portal gives you all the tools you need to create and customize applications. You don't need to install anything on your machine. All you need is a web browser. To get started, you pick an environment to work in by clicking here on the top right menu. We'll switch to that facilities environment to get started. If you look here at the left, you have all the tools you need to create applications, edit existing ones, and deploy prepackaged customizations to the environment. If you're looking to deliver the experience that I showed earlier, you can customize the Project Power App yourself here. Or you can deploy the customizations via the Project for the Web Accelerator. The accelerator is a free starter solution that you can download and install on any environment that has projects. To deploy it, we'll switch to the Solutions menu item here. Solutions are a way of packaging customizations and applications that you can use in your environment. This environment has several solutions already deployed to it. Here you can see the solutions needed to run project. To deploy the accelerator, you first need to download the zip file. And once you have it, you can go to the import button, browse to the location that you downloaded it, and then just begin the import process. There are a couple steps here that you'll just work through around configuration. And when you're done, press import. Let's change gears for a moment. I've shown you how easy it is to enable different scenarios by creating environments, deploying projects, and applying powerful customizations using the accelerator. But to be able to work effectively, project managers need a single place where they can go to reach all their projects. That single place is Project Home. To get there, click on the waffle and press the Project button. Through Project Home, we've made it easy for your project managers to quickly reach all of their projects, regardless of which environment the project is in. In Home, they'll see projects that they've accessed recently, as well as favorites that they've pinned.
In this brief presentation, we've taken a look at how easy it is to enable more advanced scenarios for deploying project. If you'd like to learn more about how project can help your organization manage their work, take a look at the links that accompany this video. I'm Alexander Luerta. Thank you for your time.